Morning to one and all. I'm Apurva Sahu and...
And my name is Pranavi Bhondwe and we are from River Ganga.
So guys, the topic for our presentation is...
Challenges faced by Samsung in mobile segment.
So guys, I would like to ask one question to all of you. Tell me honestly, how many of you guys have used Samsung mobiles at least once in your lifetime? Almost all.
Okay, now that's a very good number. So keep your hands up. I would like to ask you guys a question. So how many of you guys have gotten irritated by the fact that your phone keeps hanging again and again? Yeah, I know.
Same. Yeah. It's really irritating, man, right?
Exactly.
So we'll get back to our topic. Now I'll show you a video. So I would ask everybody of you to participate and tell me what kind of video you want to see. Should I show a funny video or a romantic video?
Okay, so on huge public demand, we are going to show a romantic video. Can we have the video? It was a cute video, right? Yeah, only getting a girlfriend was this easy, right, engineers?
Engineers, please.
Yeah.
Okay, so I would start with objective. The objective behind taking this topic was, like, while we were growing up, we were very fond of Samsung mobiles because we were, you know, school days and college days, like mobiles like Samsung Champ, Samsung Music and everything. So, there was a sudden fall and there was a negative mouth publicity. So we wanted to explore the reasons why this was happening. So this was the objective. So now I would tell you the contents. Contents are introduction, products, competitive analysis, financials, market share, reason for the downfall, and the conclusion. Introduction. Company's name, Samsung, obviously. It was founded on 1st March 1938. Founded by, guys, it's a difficult pronunciation, it's Lee Byung-chul. Headquarters, it's in Seoul, South Korea. Area served, Samsung operates worldwide. And services, advertising, entertainment, ship manufacturing, then hospitality, information and communication. Products.
Talking about the products, Samsung is an electronic company which manufactures various electronics like home appliances and everything. But since our topic is about mobile segment, we will mainly focus on the products that is smartphones. So the first one is Samsung Galaxy S series, which is the premium series. Then there is Samsung Galaxy M series, A series, there are phablets, and then there are Galaxy Fold as well. So, competitors analysis, Samsung manufactures products in all the segments, that is mass segment, mid segment, as well as premium segment. There are various competitors which give them competition in certain segments. For example, OnePlus. OnePlus manufactures phones in premium segment where, for example, there's this product Samsung Galaxy S10, which is for 72,000, and the competitive product product by OnePlus is OnePlus 7 Pro, which is for 52,000 with far more better features. Samsung Galaxy S10 has 64 GB memory, whereas OnePlus has 248 GB memory, so even better features. Likewise, the mass segment, which is the main revenue generating segment of Samsung, so Xiaomi is giving tough competition in mass segment with its Redmi Note series. The range for Redmi Note series is around 8,000 to 12,000, whereas Galaxy A30 is still 15,000, and Redmi Note series have better features than the Galaxy A10. Likewise, there are Realme provides competition in mass segment, and Vivo V15 Pro provides competition in mid segment. Next slide.
First, Pranavi, I would like to ask them a question.
Sure.
Just an example. So guys, tell me, if you have, it's a situation, right? So if you have 15,000 rupees right now in your pockets and you want to buy a new phone, just tell me the brands which just first comes into your brain. Please be loud, you guys are sleeping. Xiaomi, Vivo, okay. So this was an example that
so
nobody...
So that's a huge competition, right? So what the problem with this thing is, see, the competitors of Samsung have very price-aggressive marketing strategy, which is followed by Xiaomi and Vivo. Apart from that, these Chinese rivals have some amazing promotional... they have influential people as their brand ambassador. For example, Vivo has Amir Khan. Xiaomi has our gully boy Ranveer Singh, and Oppo has Vicky Kaushal. But in Samsung, they do not have such an influential figure.
There's no brand ambassador for Samsung. Now we come to financials. So guys, as you can see, for financial years 2016 and 17, the revenue was 55,511 crores, but for 2017 and 18 it grew by 61,065 crores. But now, like, you can see the profit over there, it is decreasing. I mean, for 2016-17 it was 4109 crores, and for 2017 and 18 this was 3712 crores. So the reason behind that was, it is approximately 10 to 11% of profit, decrease in profit. The reason behind is very simple. Samsung doesn't just, you know, work in mobile segment. It also works for, like, it provides chips and semiconductors to companies like Apple. So, and the level of production, mass production for them is very large, very, very large. Actually, so you know, Chinese companies like Xiaomi, Vivo, and like Oppo, the production level of them cannot match Samsung's. So that's why there's difference, right? Market share.
Talking about market share, here we have two comparison. One is market share of 2014 and 15, another one is the market share of 17 and 18. In 2014 and 15, you can see the market is dominated by Xiaomi, Samsung, followed by Xiaomi, the Oppo, and also we can see the huge chunk, like 35% of the market is followed by other. So these others are Carbon, Lava, Micromax, etc. And as in 2017 and 18, you can see that the 35,000 has deprecated to 18,000 because the most of the market is dominated by Xiaomi, which is now on top, made a huge progress. Second one is Samsung.
So now the reasons for downfall, our main topic, this is the main slide. So the Chinese rivals providing same features at lower cost. Guys, when these Chinese companies came to India, they followed aggressive pricing strategies. Then capture
of online market by competitors. Earlier, Samsung wasn't focusing that much on its online market, but once the OnePlus entered the mobile segment, it drastically changed the online market, and it gave a huge tough competition to Samsung over there.
Now, next. The multiple software and hardware issues. People using Samsung, they knew that, hardware, it was the battery backup. It was not that great. Software, if we talk about, they didn't used to give, this update, software updates every month. But this Chinese companies, they used to give it for every month. And there were issues like death syndrome and mobile getting blackout. Then there is negative
mouth. Next point is negative mouth publicity. Like I asked the question earlier, the problem where there's frozen screen and everything. See, the earlier the Samsung phone had lots of...
Thank you so much.